Good morning or good afternoon, everyone. I would like to welcome every who is attending our webinar, where you will learn about classification, qualification and monitoring. I would like to introduce myself. My name is Maurizio Della Pietra, Associated Product Line Manager of Particle Measuring Systems. I want to spend just a few words before starting to go in depth into the topic of why we decided to dedicate a speech to that. I have 15 years of experience in the pharmaceutical validation and I touch every day with my hand the confusion that there is about that argument. To date, there was the clear description of the meaning of each operation and their correlation. With the last draft of the Annex 1, for the first time, we can find a clear explanation about that in the regulation. Together, we will give the correct definition of classification and what we must do to comply with the standard. Then, we will analyze what the requirements given from the draft of the Annex 1 are to qualify a clean room. And lastly, I will talk about the meaning of environmental monitoring and how it's correlated with the qualification. The first question that we must do is, what's the definition of classification? The draft report more or less the same definition that we can find in the ISO 14644 Part 1 published in 2015. The classification is a method of assessing the level of cleanliness against a specification. The ISO gives the specification that we must comply with. Nothing has changed regarding the association between the pharmaceutical grades and the ISO classes. A and B must comply with the ISO 5 requirement in at-risk comatose state. Grade C, the ISO 7, and a grade D, the ISO 8. To grade that a clean room or a clear zone created by an equipment is classified, we must measure the total particle in two different occupancy states, at rest and in operation. The Annex 1 becomes aligned to the ISO regarding the classification points. We can follow the table that we can find inside the ISO with just one peculiarity. We must take care to analyze all critical processing zones with a documented risk assessment where we want to classify grade A and B. Is it the same risk assessment that we must do for the monitoring? The answer is no, because the focus of this specification is not to study the process, but to be sure to cover all the critical zones where the process is statistically. Another significant change that is in reality in alignment with the ISO is that due to the low concentration of the microparticles in the low contamination areas as grade A and B are, we should measure only the particle with an average size greater than 0.5 micron. The Annex 1 asks that we should also evaluate the measurement of the particles greater than 1 micron, but we will go in depth of the reason for that in another dedicated webinar. Going on, notice the changes for grade C and D. I report a new table of the classification limits for your convenience. Talking about qualification, what's the right definition? The draft clarifies that is the overall process to assess the level of compliance of a classified cleanroom with its intended use. Using simpler words, classification and qualification is not the same thing. The qualification is a wider process that contains the classification inside. Like all the qualification process must comply with all the formal requirements of the Annex 15 and all the verification required must comply with the testing methodologies indicated in the ISO 14644 Part 3 published last year. In detail, which are the verification needed to be added to the classification? The new draft is very clear. I reported the list of verification you can find inside it. It's nothing new. Everybody knows this test. Just one, in my opinion, needs an explanation. It's the number 5, microbial, airborne and surface contamination. We must measure the microbial contamination, both air and surface, in two different occupancy states, at rest and in operation. In this case, we not have a guideline as reference, so the number and the location of sampling points must be decided case by case with a documented risk assessment. Again, is this the same risk assessment we must do for the microbial monitoring? The answer is no once again. The focus of this verification is to create a map, a microbial characterization of the clean room, and not a measure of contamination level or the production process. Another important clarification of this draft is about the requalification that must be executed at least every 6 months for the grade A and B and at least every year for the other grades. The new draft also specified the tests needed and after which changes or extraordinary events we must requalify cleanroom. The last question that we must do is what's the definition of monitoring? Look at the drawing. The first evidence is that overlap with the qualification and classification is tiny. Why? Because the goal of the monitoring is to assess the potential contamination risk of the product. The critical focus of monitoring is the manufacturing process. The only connection with the qualification is that, as secondary purpose, we also provide evidence of the performance of the cleanroom from the process point of view. Because we must monitor our manufacturing process to decide where to sample our environment, we have to take in account all the variables into the game. The product, the process, the facility, the equipment, the operation, our historical data, the qualification data, the microbial flora that we have identified. So it's clear that we need a comprehensive risk analysis and, with a different purpose, respect what we have seen before in the classification and qualification phases. Nothing new is in which way we must monitor. Regarding the total particle, we had to measure the airborne particulate concentration of both dimensions 0.5 micron and 5.0 micron for all the grades. Regarding the viral monitoring, the new drafts confirmed what we have seen into the previous drafts. A combination of methods is a requirement, saddle plates, volumetric air sampling, gloves, gown and surface sampling with swabs and or contact plates. Our contamination control advisory team can support you through the application of all that we have seen. Our experts highly specialized in the application of risk analysis tool, and the team has more than 70 years of experience in the pharmaceutical world. We can support you with our environmental monitoring risk analysis service, defining the sampling points, the sampling frequency, the sampling methodology to apply, and to give you all the rationales to mitigate the risk found. Other services on these topics are available, as for example, the qualification load risk assessment that, as we have seen together, is fundamental during the qualification phase. Classification, qualification, and monitoring are the core or particle measuring systems solutions. Facility Pro help you to continuously monitor your environment during the manufacturing, simplify your operation, minimize the risk of contamination during the sampling of critical areas, and help you to react and control the contamination, improving the quality of your product and assuring the integrity of the data acquired. The integration with Farm Integrity, our top data management solution, creates a complete contamination monitoring solution, giving you the control of the environmental data during all phases from the material preparation to the on-field sampling to the analysis and data trending. We have reached the end of this brief webinar. Thanks for the attentiveness and please stay in touch for other insights on the new draft of the Annex 1. Have a great day.